like I said, I'm not going to try to pour paint out. There's just not enough to do. So I'm just going to dunk my roller in here, and then I'm going to use this to straighten the roller out a little bit. This green does not cover as well as the blue, so it will definitely take two coats. I could probably get away with just one coat with the blue, but I'm going to do two on that also. But you know, here I'm not trying to pound it on. I just want to get a nice base coat and make sure that I'm getting it on nice and straight without gloops and drips. That's what my goal is here on this first coat. Just cover it up nice and uniform, get that nice texture going with this roller. You can get a fantastic texture if you don't get too far ahead of yourself. And I'm going to have to come back in and hit that again. So this is probably all the paint I need right now for this coat. I can already feel it kind of wanting to set up on me, so I want to get this rolled out as straight as I can. That's good, I like it. That's a nice, even first coat. Okay, so now I'm going to take my plastic bag here. Slip it off of this, and again I want to leave it with the paint here. So I want to grab my roller like this. Now the writing and the printing of the bag is on the outside, and here I want to take this piece of scrap steel and slip it in there, because ideally I don't want the plastic bag to be touching my roller. So I'll just try to punch up around here, make a little thing like this. Take a piece of tape. So see, it's kind of in there, but it's not really touching very much. So that I can leave, you know, I can definitely wait 7 or 8 hours when I can put another coat on here and take care of that other coat. So let me switch over here to blue. Get out the roller for the blue. Close this up, try to keep it clean. Hopefully I won't need that for quite some time. Again, I'm not trying to put this on real heavy. Making a mess. Get these ends covered up. And that's good. And again, I'm going to take the plastic bag. Slip the other end of that metal stick in here. And like I said, I got about a 90% chance of being able to reuse this roller if I use it this evening, put my second coat on. So it's not really touching in there, it's a little light away from there. So just kind of set this aside. lunchtime.
Okay, that first coat I
put on was at about 10:30 this morning, and this is about 7 o'clock the same day. And I've just taken a little 220, and I'm just kind of knocking some of the dust that kind of settled on it. I had my fan blowing on it. I probably stirred some dust up and had it, you know, settle down on there. And on this one here, you can see where I had the lap mark from sitting the thing up on the 2x4. But I'll go ahead and cover that up and have it on this side this time. Got a run right there. It's going to be on the back side, but let me just go ahead and see if I can just knock that down. This will definitely cover this time. And I'm just going to dip right out of the can. I'm not even going to mess with anything else. It's going to be just fine. Oh, it still feels soft and flexible. So it's barely set up. Saved me a couple bucks. Laid out. Let me flip this up because this is up. Make sure I get that notch real good. That covered up real good. This is going to get covered by the tubing down here. This is not nearly as, but it's looking good. Just get it out. You just don't have a whole lot of time to mess with this paint. You just want to get it out and get the right texture with this roller and be done with it. I'm done. And so I'm not going to try to save this. Straighten everything out one last time here, make sure everything looks good. Okay, so I'm just using my cordless drill and I have the quarter 20 tap in here, and I'm just I got the clutch all the way open, so I'm just coming down in here and just cutting that paint out of those threads. Okay, I'm ready to do the final install. The paint is, I finished painting this last night, so the paint is still a little soft, so I want to try to be a little careful with this, but I got to just get on with it. I got other stuff to do, so I just need to get this in place and just let it dry in place. Okay, you'll see that I also cut some quarter inch pieces of flat stock, and I'm going to put these on the back side against the wood, and then I'll put my washer, lock washer and nut against this, so the washer and nut and stuff just doesn't pull into the wood.
Okay, I've got the plate and washer, lock washer and nut finger tight on the back side of these, so I can, you know, I can still move it a little bit. So let me get the tubing in place. Again, I'm trying not to scuff too much up, you know, since the paint is still real soft. This is definitely a slow cure paint. But when it hardens up, man, it's there forever. You can see I slipped a few pieces of scrap paper in here in between the aluminum and the paint. You know, paper is about 4,000ths of an inch, so I'm in 8,000ths of an inch. It's still parallel. That's the key thing. Your 3/4 is the minimum. I just don't want to scratch up my paint too much. And so now I want to give these guys a good tighten down here. This is just finger tight. This is all I can do with one of these like this, especially as sore as my wrist is right now. And then I'll switch to this. Again, I want to stress you can use 1/4-20 hex bolts here if you wanted to. You know, I just have a whole bunch of these cap screws. That's why I'm using them. Okay, let's clamp this here with our Bessies. I'll put that there just to keep the clamp off the paint. You know, if I had time, I'd let this sit for a few days. But I just really need to be done with this and move on. Okay, so I've already got the bolts inside, the nuts and washers and stuff inside. And the nice thing about using the flathead is you generally don't even have to put an Allen key. I have a couple cut off short Allen keys if I ever have to. But generally with that much surface area on that conic section, the bolt generally doesn't spin. But I'm going to take this out right now just so I can make sure that I'm not getting any rotation. Thumb on it, I can feel if it's spinning. Yeah, it's not moving at all. It's just, especially biting into that paint that's inside that countersink. It's a good idea to put a piece of plate as a big washer if you are bolting to wood. Even, you know, the mahogany's not super hard. And so, I mean, when I did my test fit, I reached in there and I could feel that washer had kind of eaten into the mahogany, and this is just going to really distribute the load a lot better. This is the one that's in the tightest spot over here. just take these off so I don't scuff the paint with that. Oh, I scuffed it a little bit. I can touch it up. Next time I'm doing some blue, I'll just come in here and just roll on top of it. It's okay. It's a table saw fence. It's going to get beat up. You know, it's just been, you know, I painted last night at about 7 o'clock, and it's early afternoon right now, so just, you know, not even 24 hours. Okay, let me clean up a little bit here, and I'll take my very super cool tools fence and put it over here and lock it down in place. Take a look at it. Okay, well this is done. So let me put this my T square on here for the first time, and we'll just see how this works. I don't want to move it around too much because I want the paint to still soft. Look at that. It's easy to make guide rails. So I hope you saw how simple the process is, whether you're making them just 3 feet long or 7 feet long, the process is the same. And I'm always available to answer questions if something doesn't make sense in my videos. And just, it's a great way to upgrade a table saw, bandsaw, or router table.